Hi DIYers, Sterling from Alarm Grid here, and today we're going to show you how to set up and use your panic alarms for your LYNX Touch L5100 security system. So first of all, the panic alarm is this button right here on your keypad. If you press and hold it for 5 seconds, it'll switch over to the panic screen and you have icons for police and fire. This is how the system ships as default. Panic for silent police and fire are both turned on by default. There is also a medical panic available, but you do have to enable it through programming. So what we're going to do is show you how to program them, and then we'll show you how to trip them. So first of all, you have to go into your zone programming section through installer mode programming. So you hit more, tools, enter your installer code, which is default 4112, and you set up your panics through the zone programming. So we need to go into program option, system switches over to system programming, you click on zones, and by default fire is set to zone 95 and the silent police panic is set to zone 99. So you have to hit the down arrow, scroll all the way through the available 64 zones, then you've got your temperature zones for thermostats, and finally the last three options are 95 fire, 96 medical, and 99 police. As I said before, fire and police are already turned on, so you really don't need to change it. But if you did want to make sure yours was on, you would choose fire, click edit. You can see there's no zone description because by default it's already showing you the icon. There is no zone description needed. There's no serial number because obviously it's not a wireless sensor like your other zones. It's set to default fire with no verification. Alarm report is set to yes, so that's what I mean by it's on by default. It will send the signal to the central station. And supervision is set to panic trigger, meaning there's no supervision needed because again, it's not a sensor and there's no chime. Everything is set up properly. If we back out and we go into medical, which this one is not on by default, we'll see that device type is medical, response type is not used. If you want to enable your medical, click into it. They give you the two options, auxiliary, 24-hour auxiliary, or 24-hour audible. Both of these are 24-hour zones. They can be tripped if the system is armed or disarmed. And basically, auxiliary will make so just the keypad beeps. Audible will make so that the full alarm goes off. So for medical, most people use auxiliary. You know, if someone has a slip and fall or there's a medical emergency in the house, you don't need the whole siren to further complicate the issue. You just want the keypad to beep and you want the signal to go to the central station. So we'll choose 24-hour auxiliary. It's already set for alarm report. So if your system is monitored, this will send a signal to the central station when this panic is triggered. And we finally make sure we save it. Before we exit out, we're going to show you that police is also on. And police is set to 24-hour silent by default. If you would rather have this be an audible alarm, let's say you're home, you hear a window smash, you want to have the alarm go off to scare away the intruder, you could toggle this over to 24-hour audible, save it, and then if we back out of programming, making sure we allow installer to re-enter when we exit, and we go back to the home screen, now when we press and hold the panic button, we now have all three icons because we have now enabled medical. To have it trip, all you do is you hit the icon. Alarm is going off. We have our system on test with our central station, so no response is coming out, but normally that would have police on its way with no verification calls needed. Because of the nature of how you trip this alarm, it's not going to be something that you do by accident, so we normally recommend when people get monitoring for their LYNX Touch that they have us send out the authorities right away when any of the panics are tripped. You know, people are worried on normal Honeywell keypads that you may inadvertently hit the panic. On the LYNX Touch, it's much harder to do because, again, you have to press and hold this for 5 seconds and then also a second action of triggering the specific panic that you want. We'll show you how the medical, we just did the police, that was full alarm. We'll show you how the medical just does the keypad alarm. Just timed out on me. Go back in. When we hit medical, different tone, just the keypad. So that is how you set up and use your panic alarms on your LYNX Touch L5100 system. If you have any questions on setting up or using your panics, please leave us a comment below. And make sure also to subscribe to our channel for future videos.